What I'd like to do tonight is I'd like to honor some people. All of you have done some wonderful stuff. I say this over and over again, but I remember after the change of command, we came back to the office, and it was Doug Schroeder, Eva Ciccoli, and myself. That's all it was. That's all it was. That we had gathered together. A lot of you were already working in dental clinics and doing your thing and doing a great job. And you didn't get the tap on the shoulder to come up and help us yet. And then we happened to get very, very fortunate in being able to get some of our staff and other people that have helped us. And so I'd like to honor some of the people that have been with us, not quite from the beginning, before we get in and say goodbye to the people that are going. So what I think I'll do is instead of having you stand up, at least for the people I'm going to honor first, just let me know where you are and I'll deliver your certificate or whatever it is, okay? I get to do this twice on you today. You're going to have to salute this guy. You should have seen Dr. Cohen trying to march today.
about it to the day, I guess. In fact, I met you at Claver in processing. And Colonel Krantz at that time said, well, you're going to be my new clinic commander at Wiesbaden. I said, hot dog, that sounds great. And then I asked Sergeant Pascos, who was, I said, you know, what the hell is a clinic command? I had absolutely no idea. I came here basically not knowing what to do, not having any schooling in it, and I muddled through it. I learned that, yeah, you can chapter people out of the Army and give them R15s, unfortunately, but I also learned to write OERs and submit awards and manage clinics. So I made a lot of mistakes. I'll tell people I'm so smart because I learned by my errors, and I made lots of errors. And I want to thank you two gentlemen for putting up with my errors and helping me, and also the staff of headquarters who I constantly harass. When I come up there monthly, they know I'm there because I'm running up and down the halls yelling, I need this and that. I see soldiers with the 464th and tell them, hey, you want to move the Wiesbaden? Every time I see Gerhardt, where's my E3? So thank everybody for putting up with me. And I thank my OICs and staff at my outline clinics for your support. That's what makes it work, so I appreciate that. Thank you.
Well, this was a tough job. But before I go into that, I want to echo what Colonel Krantz said about Roger. And everything he said was true. And I think Colonel Krantz even understated some of Roger's achievements. Roger's made my life very easy down at Shea because I could concentrate on Shea and not have to worry about weight on the moment. And probably should say this, but I will. That award he got today is just part of the awards he's getting. And hopefully something much bigger will be awarded. Long story, and I won't bore you with it, but Roger is getting another award, and I appreciate it. Now, getting on with the other matters at hand, it was very tough to come up with any kind of a gift for Colonel Krantz. I mean, I've talked to all kinds of people all over the business. Elvin Mitchell called me and said, I heard that you're having trouble. I said, yeah, Elvin, I really am. She gave me some pretty good ideas, and she said, you know, the man has everything, and we all agreed to that, and he drives his big fancy car, and there's really nothing we can get him for that big fancy car, because they took care of that at Sonhofen, and so the more I thought, and Maria said, well, you know, he does have two great loves in his life. And I said, well, you know, maybe I can do something for the two great loves. And I said, well, what are the loves? He said, well, his dog and his wife. Turn those around. So,
you gotta ring a bell.
This is for old Ben.
Okay.
And,
do I open or let him open?
Well, whatever. And Alice, this is. This is for you.
Ben will appreciate that.
And Bill, did you talk to him? You know, when I call down there, 90% of the time, this man takes care of my needs. And I don't even have to go to the big boss. I swear, every time I call, he does take care of my needs, and we're very well taken care of. So, Bill, I appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Well, along the same lines, we didn't want you to forget the little country of Belgium. It's very easy because we're small and kind of away. Probably the first thing Belgium famous for is Belgian waffles. I'll take some Belgian waffles with you on the way. Shape and NATO, Colonel Krantz would know, we deal with all the different countries. You know, he has to deal with the Italians down in Vicenza and the Army, Belgium, Germany. appropriate to give you a coffee mug about the perfect European. Actually, we got two. We got one also for Major Edison.
Thank you. I can put beer in this too.
We also didn't want to forget you along the beer mug line, and we thought we'd get you also a beer mug from Belgium.
Oh, thank you.
Probably last but not least, I heard that Colonel Krantz is a beer connoisseur. And anybody who's been to Belgium knows that they have a statue there that's very famous. No beer connoisseur can be without his mannequin piss, beer opener, wine.
Chicken or something like that. Steve would bring out fresh chicken and a salad. So he brought out fresh chicken and a salad. Carl comes over to me and says, "Damn, I hate to bother you, but can you get the waiter to cook this chicken a little bit longer?" I said, "Well, why? What's wrong?" He said, "I need my salad." Well, I learned my lesson about seafood in Colonel Krantz. So what I did was, he's going to be going to one of the seafood capitals of the world. And everybody's going to say, "Man, you got to try the blue crab." So I figured I better get you a sign so that people know you don't want no critters. Tried our pizzas, and he found this one that's guaranteed to bring your cholesterol up to at least 400. It's called a Canada Daisy, and it's got Canadian bacon and about four or five different types of hams. Everything. So if you ever get back to Italy, we got you a lifetime supply of pizza Canada Daisy from the Old Quarter Napoli Pizzeria, your favorite pizzeria.
Yeah, I might hold you to it.
Okay. 76 to 80, 82 to right now. And when I was the chief field NCO, us NCOs used to give each other what we called a CTAP line. And I started something when I was a senior NCO with every general commander I served for and every general. We used to have generals up in Heidelberg. And Colonel Krantz is about the closest thing to a general dental officer we got over here. And I didn't want to break your tradition. So I want to present you with the Lion of St. Mark's Award presented to Colonel William A. Krantz, Commander of European Regional Dental Command, for outstanding support of the Chisholm Dental Clinic Command, 8 July 94, 22 July 97. Thank you.
Prostodontics 101 for you, and I think maybe you can study this on the way to Fort Houston.
Okay, well, you gave me this afternoon.
I'm not done with you. Sit down.
Yes, sir.
As he's already admitted, Italy has been his favorite place to come down. We've probably seen him more in Italy than any of the rest of you in this room. He puts on, he has a lot of important business to do. A lot of it takes tri-service type cooperation. And he's got conferences that come up time to time where he gets all these tri-services together. He's got one coming up at the end of May. And he called and let me know. He said, you know, Dennis, I got this thing down at Camp Darby. He said, your predecessor always did me a big favor and got me free beach passes when I came down. So, sir, we got you another free beach pass. So you can have your
so you can fish.
Why are you doing all that? He's also very, very good about supporting us and giving us supply dollars when we need supply dollars. And I had, and this has come up just recently where I realized that I mistakenly had something in our clinic that didn't really belong to us. And I needed to replace that item. Colonel Slopey, you want to come over? You know, Colonel Slopey, most of you don't know, he started out in Vicenza back, 1983? Eight?
Okay.
Eight more?
It's been a while, eh?
Anyway, he has kind of hot fingers, too, because he managed to lift a kitchen knife from the facility down there and engraved his name on it. And we've been utilizing that kitchen knife in our laboratory since 1981.
I came from
dental
school.
Okay, well, that's good to know. Because that CID agent was real. So we have this certificate of appreciation from Colonel Dennis L. Slopey for enduring support of the Vicenza Dental Clinic from August 1981 to April 1997. Your unselfish contribution of your personal kitchen knife was the key to the unparalleled successful operations of the Vicenza Dental Clinic Laboratory supported in Northern Italy, American military community. As Commander of U.S. Army Dental Clinic Command, Vicenza Italy, I commend you for your lasting devotion and express my sincere appreciation to Colonel Krantz for allowing the command to purchase a new replacement knife and return the original to its owner. The last thing I have here, I've met a lot of important people since I've been down in Italy, and one of them was the mayor of Vicenza, and I met him the other day, and I was telling him about Colonel Krantz, and a glow came to his eyes when I mentioned Krantz, and he said, we really like it when the Krantzes come to town. He said, the economic boost to our economy is just And I mentioned the fact that Francis was going back to the station, and he said, we got to get a crisis actions team together and figure out what we're going to do to replace the economic loss that we're going to have at Vicenza. So anyway, he wanted to make you an honorary citizen. So W.A. Krantz, for the numerous times he has blessed us with his presence throughout these many years, also in gratitude for the monetary support his wife has provided us with her fast shopping trips for gold, ceramics, and leather goods. Given this the first day of May in the year of our Lord, 1997, Mayor of Vicenza. Vino Rosa.
Wonders on a laser printer.
It's an old looking key to go along with that.
Still rough it up on the trip home. All joking aside, Colonel Krantz has been a tremendous person to work for. Whether or not he believes in total quality management, it's a good thing he does because he has too many other things to worry about besides Italy. And that's a tremendous advantage to me. He empowers me to give me the organization, give me the tools to work with, and just supports me in every way that I have had down there at Vicenza. And as a result, I really appreciate what you do and allow us to do in Vicenza. So you have what's a limited edition of a dental crest that was made south of Naples. That says, Colonel William A. Krantz, for outstanding support of the Vicenza Dental Clinic Command, Vicenza, Italy. This is from all of us down at Vicenza.
I tried to do a little research with this next topic, and and I don't know if you know anything about heraldry. I know Colonel Krantz does because he likes medieval things and times and history, but heraldry is actually an identification system using visual symbols, and normally this was on coats of arms. And as far as we can learn right now, heraldry probably came into effect in Western Europe in the 12th century. basically, these coats of arms were worn by the warriors and the soldiers on the battlefields to identify themselves so that, you know, they could be not slain by their fellows, because of the fact their faces were covered with head helmets and headpieces, as you can tell by looking at the table of the Edissa Knights. Also, the Edissa has a crest, a coat of arms, which was designed by Colonel Krantz. And I remember him when he first took the job, you know, when he came to an officer's call one day and at the OIC meeting, and he says, "This is going to be the new Edissa crest. I'm getting coins made. If you're lucky, maybe y'all will get them." And he's been very generous, and he's given them to all, everybody, and that's great. We appreciate that, and we'll cherish that forever. But we started this last year. We found a lady that would do this for us, and what we have done for you, and we won't let you see it just yet, but if you, I think everybody can kind of see one of these knights that's on the table. This crest does have a story behind it, and I passed out some papers earlier in the evening to some of the OICs, and they're going to tell you a little bit about the story of this crest and what each of these things on the crest stands for. So I'll let them have the story now, and then we'll go ahead with the rest of the presentation. So, Jim, would you like to?
So, if you notice the crest, the blue band with gold stars is derived from the European Community flag. Three stars stand for the three European country nations within which the European district is located.
In the blue background and white lion are the traditional colors of the medical department.
The white lion represents the community where the command's DENTACs are located. All have lions in the area's crest.
And the three legs on the lion represent the three end state DENTACs: Landstuhl, Heidelberg, and Würzburg.
And the lion is holding the traditional symbol of the medical system, the Red Cross.
So, sir, from all of the officers in the Landstuhl DENTAC, we would like to present you with this Edissa crest.
Okay.
Be careful when you open it, because I don't want to. But I'll let you go ahead and open it. And we hope you can find a nice place to hang it in your office or your home. When you get to Fort Eustis, I'm sure they will let you hang that in your office and that's not their crest. But we had this made by a lady that does stained glass for over in Ramstein. And she did a very nice job on it. We've been saving it for a long time for this day for you. It is on a hanger, so you can hang it.
You know, I think there's some sun in Virginia. Eliminate this very well. Boy, that is fun. You got it.
You did a lot of work designing it, and you deserve all the credit. So. Enjoy it. So. Appreciate all you've done for us.
Well, that is done.
We're done now, sir.
Are we? I run out of things to say, Bob.
Well,
that is really, really nice.
Okay.
That'll go in my room where I got all my notes in, and my tapestry, and all that stuff. Now I only have to find a house.
Two days.
Thank you all. It's been a great night. I won't forget it, that's for sure. I look around, and I can remember talking and working with every one of you. And the thing about it is that when I came and I've asked to do something, Never once did I need to disappoint you. You came through, and that's what makes it so great.
Thank you. Sure.
Yeah.